Words cannot express the making of this mess. Is it still too late for us to separate? That continues to be the question. Let's talk on the mic. Hello, hello, good people. This is your guy, Mr. Educator, Mr. Communicator, Mr. Free Thinker, coming back at you live once again from the Lone Star State with another edition of the Media Mike Speaks. All right, good people, it is 28 minutes past the hour, and yes, we are the voice of the everyday citizen. All right, good people, one of my subscribers hit me up and asked me, have I heard of this story? Well, the trial that's going on and the sentencing of one of the suspects here. But I do remember the story when it came out in 2019. So I looked it up and one of my subscribers asked me, well, you know, what are your thoughts on it? And I said, well, you know, I have mixed feelings about this, but I said, why not? I'll go ahead and give it a shot. So I went back and read the article. Had to do a little bit of total recall. And here we are. So yes, the former NBA player, Andre Emmett, just in case you did not know of him, he's a native son of the Lone Star State. Gunned down it wasn't an attempted armed robbery, it was a strong armed robbery. September 23rd, 2019. And the 23rd happens to be my little brother's birthday. So, anyway, we're going to talk about this. And I'm going to give my thoughts because it's some things I want to say and I continue to say. And I'm going to add some new nuances here, and I'm pretty sure, you know, I may have some detractors and naysayers. So let's get to it. We have two remaining suspects accused of killing Andre Emmett, Mr. Michael Lucky and Keith Johnson, have yet to stand trial. Mr. Larry Jenkins was just sentenced to life in prison without parole for the capital murder. The jury was unanimous. Emmett's mother, I think she did in a victim impact statement. So let me refresh your memory here on this. On the 23rd of September, 2019, Andre Emmett, he was 37 years old, father of, I do believe, two daughters, if I'm not mistaken. He was shot during a robbery while eating at Whataburger in his car in the driveway of his old East Dallas home near Lower Greenville. The former Texas Tech University basketball star was taken to a hospital where he later died. Now, Jenkins' attorney, one of the subjects who was just sentenced, told the court, it starts out with Michael Lucky, one of the other defendants, and it starts out with Keith Johnson, the other defendant. Three of them, and that their client is getting thrown in the rest of the mix. Lucky and Johnson were both indicted on capital murder charges in December of 2019. So, according to, I guess, the investigation or the evidence, Johnson and Lucky shot Mr. Emmett during a robbery in which they stole his watch and the necklace. You know, and they later posted this stuff on social media. But we'll get to all of that. Dallas police released home security video, which was captured on the late Mr. Emmett's neighbor's doorbell. in which you can hear the dozen of gunshots can be heard. Mr. Emmett was seen running from his car, getting out of his car and running away, actually. Officers and crime scene investigators with the Dallas Police Department testified Tuesday that they collected evidence from two crime scenes that were relatively close. The location where Emmett was found and the driveway of his home, which is where they said the robbery occurred. This young man was an All-American, went to Texas Tech, was drafted in 2004 by the Seattle Supersonics when they were in Seattle at the time. He played with the Memphis Grizzlies and went on to play for the New Jersey Nets. Now, good people, you really want to know how these idiots got caught. I'm not excluding the police investigation, but it was the people in the neighborhood who turned him in. After it was said that the suspects were posting things online, which they did, but of course, the $50,000 reward really, really helped, I bet. You see, when you offer that amount along with bragging rights on social media, you will make the investigation that much easier. We have to see people that we have no friends, even amongst our own. We have no friends. It is our own who gun down the productive, the ones who we say so-called made it. It is usually the productive who is gunned down by the so-called unproductive in our communities. Either they or somebody or could have been somebody. Now, the investigation mentions that some kind of tracking device was placed on the late Mr. Emmett's vehicle. Now, my question is, how did these suspects get close enough to place such a device on the vehicle? You know, just saying. But I do know that he did frequent certain places, you know, alone, you know, I wouldn't have done that, but hey, he's back home, so. But, you know, when you are of a certain caliber, whether it be high profile or successful, depending on who you know and where you go, you have to move in this world in an entirely different way. Now, I'm not blaming, but it is what it is. There are certain places that you probably can't go anymore. Certain people you can't hang around anymore. And you may have to have a CCW. It is what it is. You can't be naive to the world around you, inside or outside of your own community, especially when you have children. Because it's not about you anymore. You become a target. A high profile target, I should say. And you have to remember that everybody is not always happy about your success. Until next time, this is your guy, Mr. Educator, Mr. Communicator, Mr. Free Thinker. Subscribe, share, and like to keep me rocking on the mic. Have a good night.
They'll understand you soon, it won't be long. Keep on, keep running.